Hello and welcome to my channel, Spiritual Knowledge Institute. This is the second session we are doing on internal sound. We have given a brief introduction about internal sound. Anahatanad, or the flute of the Krishna, Manohar ki Murli, and Brahmanad, creator of the universe, this sound is. So if you do not have a basic knowledge about Nad, you can go to the first video, part one of Nad, and you can have the basic knowledge about the Nad, what it is. So today topic is, how do we differentiate Nad and tinnitus? When somebody start, you know, practicing some kind of yoga meditation or gets into any kind of initiation where the repetition or the chanting of the mantra is involved, very soon they start hearing a sound coming out of their ear. It might be coming out from your left ear or right ear or both, so it does not matter from which ear you are listening to. Sometimes there are, you know, people say you should not hear it from left ear, you should hear from right ear, but you know, this is a baseless thing to talk about because there are categorization of our body, and this is a point of discussion, and we will definitely talk about, you know, this, there is no difference between left and right, but it is the level of our ascension, level of our consciousness, why we listen it, you know, from the left ear or right ear. And you should not worry about it, that listening it from the right ear is beneficial and listening from the left ear is not beneficial. There are point of consciousness where you are, and according to that you listen it from the particular ear, because it is not coming from outside or from the ear, it is coming from your brain, and brain is all about, you know, your consciousness. So depending on the consciousness, you hear it from your particular ear. Now, how do you differentiate between tinnitus and nad? Is tinnitus is a sound which disturbs you. If you try to listen to the nad, and if you find out what is the characteristics of the nad, then first thing, nad, the internal sound, nad is internal sound, we are referring it nad. The internal sound does not fall on your ears, drums of your ears. That means you do not feel it, that it is coming through your ear or falling on your ear. Means somebody, if somebody shouts, what do you feel? You feel, oh, please stop it, you're irritating me. So you feel it on your eardrum, but the internal sound does not fall on your eardrums. This is the first thing. And when you listen to the internal sound, it is very soothing. It is constant, rhythmic, one sound. It might be, you know, sound of cricket. It might be a sound of whistle. It might be a sound of bells. These are the three basic sound which we hear. Maybe different sounds at a same time from 2 ears we can hear. So we should concentrate on the sound which is in the lower volume, because the lower volume tells us about the deeper conscious level, because the internal sound is a vehicle which takes us in the deeper conscious. So the sound which is the lower is define the deeper conscious. So if we are listening to sounds, different sounds, then concentrate on the sound which is lower. So now tinnitus, the sound, second characteristics is second or third, when you listen to the nad, you cannot concentrate on the nad for a very long time. You will try to listen to the nad, you concentrate on the sound very closely, you will go into the thought process. Lot of thoughts will start coming. You will, after some time, you will realize, oh, I started thinking, I was listening to the nad. So if it happens, and when you start listening to the internal sound and you go into the thought processes, that means it is not tinnitus, it is internal sound which is, it is taking you into your deeper conscious. When we find peace, why we are finding peace? Because there are lot of thought processes. Because there are a lot of thought processes are going on into your mind. So how do you find peace? You can only find peace when you pierced through those thought processes. And this is only the internal sound which helps you to find the peace. So when you start listening to the sound properly with high concentration, with pure concentration, after 3, 4, 5, 7 or 10 seconds, you go into your thought processes. Every time you do it, every time you go into the thought processes. When you keep on practicing this, listening to this internal sound, you start falling asleep. And this is where your mind goes into the peace. There is no thought process. You are into the deeper conscious state where no thought process, no voices, nothing is there. So when you wake up, you come out of your, you know, this sleep. We call it tantra. This is, you know, the term we use in the yoga, which is called tantra. This is not a normal sleep we take. This is a very special sleep which introduces us to peace, which helps us to find peace within us. So when you wake up from that tantra, you feel, oh, I was not sleeping, I was listening to the nad. When did I fall asleep? So this was the question. This will be the first question arise into your mind, and this is how you identify. This is not tinnitus, this is internal sound. You know, people listen to the nad, internal sound, for very long years, but they get irritated by it. They say in the night the internal sound, the tinnitus, is louder and they are not able to sleep, their blood pressure is rising, lot of problems, because they are not listening to it. They are running from the nad. They do not know that this is a nad, we have to hear it. And if somebody starts listening to the nad and he starts avoiding it, the internal sound starts getting louder, because this is the sound within us. This is calling us towards peace and we are avoiding it. And we go to the doctor. Doctor say, this is tinnitus, it will wake you up in the night, it will get louder. You say, yes, it happens. Internal sound makes you, you know, wakes you up during midnight at 2:30, 2 a.m., you know, 3 a.m., generally 2 or between 2 or 3 a.m., 2:30 a.m. It wakes you up because it wants you to hear it, because at this time outside noise is zero. You know, there is no noise outside. So it wakes you up that you should listen to it during night. So when you start hearing this nad, it wakes you up during night. This is also an identification for the nad. So if it is not falling on your drums, if listening to it taking you into the thought process, if after some time, some seconds, it is taking you into sleep, deep sleep, and you have a question, I was not sleeping, I was listening to it, and the last one we discuss, it is waking you up in the midnight, 2 a.m., 2:30 a.m. So that means it is internal sound, and this is very sacred. You must listen to it. It is only the vehicle which can take you to the higher conscious and in a deeper level of meditations. Okay, this is the difference between. And about tinnitus is definitely, it should be a sound of crackling sound or something which disturbs you, which falls on your drums. So I do not know about tinnitus, but I know about internal sound. So I told you about, you know, internal sound. If your symptoms, you know, are related to the explanation I have given, then you should not worry about it. You should study it. So this was the difference between tinnitus and internal sound. And we also discuss about any of the ear, you should listen to it. You should not worry about which side of the ear it is coming, because it depends on your consciousness. And in the next, we will discuss about how we study the internal sound. Okay. So this is all for this video. Please do like and subscribe this channel, Spiritual Knowledge Institute, for more videos. We will see you in the next video.